This is a very common problem with Windows 11 that sometimes you don't get Wi-Fi option at all. Doesn't matter whatever you try, but you don't get the Wi-Fi. As you can see that Wi-Fi is disconnected, and if you go to the Action Center, there is no Wi-Fi option. Bluetooth is there, but no Wi-Fi option. Even if you go to the Windows settings and then Network and Internet, there is no Wi-Fi option. Ethernet option is available, but no Wi-Fi option. So in this video, you will see different ways to get back missing Wi-Fi on your Windows 11. So let's get started. So very first thing you need to check if this is a problem related to the Wi-Fi driver, the PC hardware, or just the Windows 11 problem. For this, go to search and look for CMD and open the command prompt. Type here ping, then space 127.1.1.1, then press enter on your keyboard. If you see this kind of reply, that means there is no problem with the Wi-Fi hardware. But if you see general failure, that means it could be a problem with the Wi-Fi hardware or the network drivers. Alright, in this case, it is a problem with the Windows 11. Now the first fix you should try is, go to Windows search and look for control panel and open the system app. Go to internet options and then advanced option. Just click on restore advanced settings. Then hit apply and OK. It will just reset the advanced internet settings. Then we can try to get back our missing Wi-Fi. Now we can try to check Wi-Fi related services on our PC. Go to search and look for services and open the app. Make sure you enable the extended view and look for WLAN Autoconfig service. Make sure this service is running. If it is not running, you have to start the service. And if it is already running, you have to restart the service. So if the service is not running, then right click on it, go to properties, set the startup type as automatic and start the service. Then hit apply and OK. And if the service is already running, you will get restart option. So you have to restart the service. And then look for WLAN Autoconfig. This service should be running as well and set to automatic. Just right click on it, go to properties, set the startup type automatic and start the service. Hit apply and OK. In some cases, you will be able to get the Wi-Fi option on your PC. And if it is not working, follow the next method. Again, go to the Windows search and look for control panel and open the app. Go to Network and Sharing Center and change adapter settings. If you see Wi-Fi option here, then you have to disable and enable it. And if it is already disabled, you have to enable the Wi-Fi option. So just right click on it, then disable it. If it is already enabled, then right click again and enable. So you have to disable and enable the Wi-Fi adapter. And if you don't get the Wi-Fi option, that means driver is missing. After this, you might have to restart your PC and check for Wi-Fi. And if you don't get the Wi-Fi option, follow the next method. Again, go to the search and look for device manager and open the app. On device manager, you have to expand the network adapters. So just expand the network adapters option and you will see your Wi-Fi driver here. It might be Intel, Broadcom, Ethros, Qualcomm or any other Wi-Fi driver. But if you don't see any such Wi-Fi driver, that means the driver is missing and we have to reinstall it. So if you see the Wi-Fi driver, then right click on it and then scan for hardware changes. And if you don't see the Wi-Fi driver, then you should select your computer name at the top, then go to Action tab and scan for hardware changes and check if you are getting Wi-Fi or not. If not, right click on the driver, Wi-Fi driver again, then update driver. Since we are not connected, then browse my computer for drivers. Click on this option and then let me pick from a list of available drivers on my computer. Now ensure that so compatible hardware is enabled. And then you will get a list of Wi-Fi drivers that are compatible with the hardware on your computer. So here you can try to install the different available drivers on your PC. install the first driver first and check if that is working or not. If that is working, then fine. Otherwise, install the other drivers. Just select the driver and click on next and it will install the driver. So you have to try different available drivers and check which one is working. If none of them are working, then go back to the driver option again. Right click on it, then disable device. Click on yes option and then right click again and enable device. It is the same process as we did before to enable and disable the adapter. Now if that doesn't work, right click on it again and then go to properties. Go to power management tab. And if you see this option is checked, then you have to uncheck this option. Allow the computer to turn off the device to save power. This option should be unchecked. Then hit OK. And check if you are getting Wi-Fi option or not. If not, then try to uninstall the driver. Just right click on the driver again. And then uninstall device. Do not remove the device driver from computer. And then uninstall. Once it is uninstalled, you have to restart your PC. And after the restart, it will automatically install the Wi-Fi driver on your PC. Or you can scan for hardware changes on Device Manager if you don't want to restart the PC. But I recommend you to restart the PC and then it will get back the Wi-Fi driver. Now check if you are getting Wi-Fi option or not. If not, you can use the Windows Troubleshooter. Go to Menu, then Settings, System Settings. Scroll down to find Troubleshoot option. And then other troubleshooters. Run the troubleshooter for network and internet. And the Windows automatic troubleshooter will try to find any problem with your PC or the network drivers or hardware, and it will give you an option to fix the problem. So you just have to follow whatever it says. In my case, it is asking me to restart the network service, then enable the Wi-Fi adapter, restart your PC. So you just have to follow whatever it says. The Windows troubleshooter might fix the problem in some cases. And if these things are not working, then you can try to reset the entire network. Go to Menu again, Settings, Network and Internet option again. Then go to Advanced Network Settings. Click on Network Reset, this option, and then Reset Now, and click on Yes option. It will restart your PC. And after the restart, check if you are getting Wi-Fi options or not. If not, follow the next method. Now go to Windows search again and look for CMD and run the command prompt as admin. Click on the yes option you will see on the screen. And on the CMD, you have to try some commands. Type netsh, then space winsock, then space reset, then press enter on your keyboard. Now you have to type netsh. Then space int, then space ip, then space reset and press enter on your keyboard. These commands will fix any socket API related errors on your computer. Now you have to restart your PC and check if you are getting Wi-Fi option or not. If not, then you have to enable all the Windows services. Go to search and look for msconfig. Then open the system configuration app. And under the general tab, if you see you have selective startup enabled, then select the normal startup. Just select the top option and then apply. Now go to the services tab and make sure all the services are enabled. So you have to make sure all these services are checked. And if you are unsure, then you can just click on disable all, then click on enable all. Now hit apply and OK. And then you must restart your computer. After the restart, you will be able to get the Wi-Fi option on your PC. In case if these things are not working, then get a working device where you can access the internet. It might be your mobile phone as well. Fire up any browser and go to google.com. Now you have to search for the Wi-Fi driver for your Windows 11 laptop or PC. You might have other brands like Asus, HP, Dell, whatever. Just search for your laptop model number followed by driver. If you have custom built PC, then look for the Wi-Fi driver for the motherboard. Or if you have any network card, then look for the driver for that network card. You have to select the basic detail for your device. On the different website, you will get different interface, but anyhow, you have to look for the driver option. And then find the networking drivers and look for the Wi-Fi driver. It might show you as WLAN driver. So you have to download the latest available Wi-Fi driver from the manufacturer website. So just download this driver, the latest available Wi-Fi driver, and then transfer it to the affected Windows 11 computer and install the driver. You can use any flash drive or whatever to transfer the file and then install the WLAN driver on the affected Windows 11 computer. And after installing the driver, you have to restart your PC and then you should get back the missing Wi-Fi on your Windows 11. By any chance, if these methods are not working, then you can try the last method, which I call power flush. The power flush could be a magical way to fix the Wi-Fi problems on your PC. Basically, you have to drain all the static power from your PC. Just shut down your PC completely and remove all the power cable. Then press and hold the power key for 30 seconds and then start your PC. I have covered this method in details in the given video on the screen at this timestamp. Go watch the video, otherwise the current video will be long. So these were some methods to fix when Wi-Fi is missing on your Windows 11 PC. And that's all for this video guys, hope this helped. And two of you who are still watching, thanks for being here. I wish you all the best. Hit the subscribe button and I will see you in my next one.